Number 17 of the 2020 St. Patrick's Day tournament. So I'm in the opening round of the rookie division in my 99 count, playing with T4 clubs, and I am going to have time. If you watched all the videos up to this point, I've been on and off today, but I am going to have time to finish out these last four or five holes, and just trying to knock these last couple out. So let's go check out hole number 17. It's been one of those days you can't get into a rhythm when you're playing one hole and leaving and playing two holes and leaving. So just trying to get myself into the weekend round, and that way I can focus. What do we got here? Hole number 17 is Glen Monarch hole number 5. Glen Monarch Estates hole number 5. All right, so if the wind is, we're okay, on this shot, I'm bringing a sniper. This is plan A. Bringing a sniper. And plan A is if the wind is 3 miles an hour or less, I'm using a sniper, a Marlin, and I'm doing the rough bump. Plan B, if the wind is 3 miles an hour or greater, I'm using a Guardian, same ball, and I'm going to backspin it to the cup. So the last, on the front nine, the wind was over 3, and we're adding on 10%, so it's plus 10%. So if the wind, just the base wind, is 2.7 or lower, we're going to stick with plan A. If the base wind is higher than 2.8, 2.9, if it's higher than that, then I'm going to go with plan B. So I want to have two bags set up, one set up with a sniper and one set up. And it takes about 2.25 top spin and about 1/4 left-hand side spin to make this shot happen. So I've got bag A, bag B, and I'm bringing a Marlin. What was I thinking? Marlin. And I don't have any low wind, zero power balls. So if you've got an inventory, if you've got some of the low wind, zero power balls, then you more than likely will only have to shoot option A. But because of the way that the wind's blowing, we do want to come in with a game plan so that we don't get caught up and then have to do some scramble thing. People fail when they get thrown off. That's why when you see people go to hole and they really only like to play that hole one way, and it's not working out. So what's the wind? 4-6. So I'm going for the backspin shot, which means I'll have to switch bags. Let's dial that sucker up to the cup. I'm going to add on 10%, so that's 4-6, so that's going to be 5. It's 1.75, so there's 5-1. It's a 3-ring pull. Hit it 1 ring great to the right. Getting laggy. There's so many people on because everybody's at home because of this coronavirus. That I was a little short. That it's going to be a tough weekend round. I don't have on my tablet, I don't have it hooked up so that I just get like regular phone stuff out of it. So I'm Wi-Fi-ing. See how my opponent does. Let's see what their game plan was. Now with the Goliath, you can actually do the rough bump. This is the other way that you could come at it. Another option is you could bring that same zero power ball, or you could bring a one power ball like a navigator, and you can push your Goliath so far forward so that you're at the red line, and then you have plenty of room to adjust out whatever wind you want. And that's probably the way to play this hole because of the way that the wind is going. Then you don't have that worry, because we're hitting that red line back there. So if you bring a little bit more powerful ball, you can push the red line forward and you'll be in the same setup spot as you would be in your wood. I don't typically play with a Goliath, and it's not that I have anything personally against the Goliath. It's just I don't normally play with a Goliath in one-on-one, but in this type of shot right here, this would be a great place to bring your Goliath. especially if you have an upper developed Goliath, that would be because then you're going to get some ball guide and you're going to get a little more accuracy. I have to look at my Goliath and see what it has in this account. No good. Sly Fox DSM. I will forfeit. Good luck in the tournament. I am wiped out. Wiped out. I'm getting done with this last hole. I'm going to go to bed. It's only like 8 o'clock. I'm wiped out. Definitely getting enough here. I know it sounds weird with my low-level account, but my goal in this account is still minus 30. You have the same opportunities on those par fours. If you hit the par fours in hole number 18 and you get an eagles on the par fours and the eagle on hole number 18, you're at minus 15, you're minus 30. So minus 30 is definitely, I mean, I'm at minus 26 if I can get the eagle on hole number 9. And I know that looks like it's a mile away from minus 30, but it's all those missed. I didn't hit it perfect going in on 2. I didn't hit it perfect going in on 11. I didn't hit it perfect going in on 16. There's three shots right there. And that's the difference. And I didn't pick up the eagle on hole number 9, which was totally that's the first time this week. And it's all about the drive shot. If you get your drive shot right on hole number 9, you've got an eagle. I mean, you can get the eagle if you get that drive shot. It's the first time all week I didn't get that drive shot right. So I will see you on hole number 18 and we can see if we can get it right on the back nine and pick that up to a 26, which would be an acceptable score coming into the weekend for tiebreakers. All right. Thanks for watching.